Do you know what a voider is and how painters used it? Let's find out together by time travelling to London in the year 1676. In the late 17th century, the sundial painter, John Smith, published a book called The Art of Painting in Oil. The manual or treatise was about what he called vulgar painting, which we would think of today as painting and decorating. However, back then, the tools and technical knowledge involved in the preparation of paintings and materials was generally the same for both fine painting and decorating. The only difference was in the use of some higher grade pigments by fine painters. Smith himself was a dialist, so his work occasionally involved some fine painting too. The term dialist referred to someone who designed and made sundials. Most people told the time by the sun, and as there weren't many clocks or watches in the late 17th century, the job of the dialist was very important. So, the treatise can still be used by fine painters today to understand some of the technical aspects of painting in the late 17th century. The original readership of the treatise would have been gentlemen living outside of the capital. There were few painters based outside of cities and large towns, so it was important for gentlemen, or rather their staff, to repair and decorate the properties, including sundials. Smith starts his treatise by describing the tools of the trade and explains where they can be bought from. This was quite often from a colour shop, which was an early form of art shop, except it sold items such as tea, coffee, chocolate, and even medicine. He tells us about pencils, which was the original word for paintbrushes. These would have been in duck or swan quills, though some had wooden handles. He also goes through all the pigments and oils, as well as the tools necessary for grinding paint. Painters could buy ready prepared paint in pig or ox bladders at the colour shop. However, Smith expected readers to grind their own paints, and most painters would have actually done this, certainly for cheaper pigments. As you would expect, there are some tools that we don't recognise today, and one of these is called a voider. After describing the muller, which the painter used to crush the pigments with, Smith wrote,
"For these belong a voider, being no other than a lanthorn horn, about 3 inches one way and 4 the other. This voider is to clear off the colours from the stone when ground, and also to keep them together in the time of grinding, when it spreads too much."
His description is quite clear in that the tool is some kind of scraper for keeping the paint together on the stone as it was being ground. But the rest is curious. So, what did he mean? Firstly, we have to understand that a lot of domestic wares at this time, such as combs, cutlery, and drinking cups, were made from animal's horn. And instead of using glass, which was expensive, they often used thin, translucent slices of horn in lanterns. That's why Smith says that the tool is no other than a lanthorn horn. Lanthorn is an archaic spelling of lantern, though it was still being used in the 18th century. In fact, Dr. Johnson, in his Dictionary of the English Language of 1755, wrote that lantern was, by mistake, often written lanthorn. Smith then meant painters were to remove a piece of horn from an existing lantern, or to buy one for the purposes of grinding paint. The voider then was a piece of thin horn, which was used to scrape the paint when it was ground into the bladders. It also kept the paint and oil on the grinding stone as the painter ground the pigments and oil together. So, you now know what a voider was in the 17th century, and how painters at the time used this important tool to help them prepare paint.
Hi, I'm Micheline Heine from Parallax Art Fair TV. Thank you for watching. Remember to subscribe and tick the like button if you enjoyed the video. Leave us a comment. And for more information about Parallax Art Fair, look at the description box below. Until next time, thank you for watching.